think it will thrill you. It may shock you. It might even horrify you. So if any of you feel that you do not care to subject your nerves to such a strain, now is your chance to, well, we've warned you.
Hey guys, welcome to Happy Wax TV. So one of my followers on Facebook, Angela Kristen, I hope I said your last name right, posted on my group page, Happy Wax TV, earlier today, and this is what she wrote. It says, what's wrong with today's horror movies? I want more blood in them, oozing out of open wounds. I miss the good old days when they would show you just that, and lots of male and female nudity, the way God intended. Today we don't get that much of this in horror, but I remain optimistic. Okay, so that being said, thanks for posting that comment, Angela. I appreciate it. She actually posts quite a bit, and some of the movies that she shares on my Facebook page are incredible. So make sure you join up today. I'll leave a link to Happy Wax TV in the description box. But it's just so funny because she posted that today, and literally yesterday I got this trailer sent to me. It's called The Night of the Virgin. Now it came out in 2016, but it's finally getting released over here. It's a Spanish movie. And very quickly, it's in this horror comedy at a New Year's Eve party. Nico, a naive 20-year-old, sets out ready to lose his virginity at all costs the same night. In the middle of the party, his gazes cross Medea, a cunning and attractive mature woman. So I did a little research on this movie, and this movie is supposed to be crazily over the fucking top as far as just blood and guts and ooze and everything. So, but it's funny because one of the things that I wrote about it, one of the articles, was that Javier Bodalo, I hope I said that right, he's the main star, he plays Nico. He did all his own stunts, and I guess he had to go to the hospital a few times, and it actually delayed the filming for a couple of weeks because they had to go to the hospital and recuperate. So I'm like, all right, I need to watch this fucking trailer. So anyways, you know what? Let's watch it right now. It's called Night of the Virgin. I've been dying to watch this thing since I got it yesterday. So I have no idea what this is going to look like. So let's check it out and we'll give it a watch.
Tenías razón, ¿eh? Mucho mejor esto que la fiesta. No sé lo que habría tardado en irme, sino... Bueno, si...
Si yo no te hubiese rescatado. Tranquilo. Aquí estás a salvo. Todo va a salir bien.
¿Por qué me hacéis esto?
Shit. Okay. Wow. Okay. So yeah, they weren't wrong about this movie being fucking over the top. Even the trailer looks fucking crazy. I mean, it obviously starts off at the first act and then it gives you scenes from the first, second and third act. By the end of it, I'm like, holy fuck, what is going on in this movie? So obviously, okay. So he's met this woman, Medea, at a party, and she's brought him back to his house and she drugs him, and then obviously I'm assuming they have sex. I mean, why wouldn't you? She's fucking beautiful. But then, did you see how they progressively get more bloody, and then more people come into the fold here, and then there's one scene where she looks like she's like possessed in the fucking living room there, and her eyes roll back and are black. And like, I don't know, is this like a possession movie or like a satanic movie where he has to get sacrificed through sexual ritual? I don't know, but some of the things that they were saying, like bloody disgusting, was saying disgustingly unforgettable. And then there was another scene in here. Let me find it here. Don't eat or make love beforehand, from The Daily Dead. And then the one that really made me laugh was the most willingful disgusting movie ever made by Fright Fest. So I'm like, holy fuck, this thing is like, I don't know, I want to watch this because this thing looks fucking crazy. But if you go on to IMDb, and like I said, this thing has been out since 2016. And if you go to where it has played, let me just find it here, release dates. Okay, so this thing has played all over the world, and they showed a little clip of all the awards that it's won, like Best Horror Movie and whatever else. But it's played all the way back in October 16th. So it's played at the Atlanta Horror Film Festival, Columbus Nightmare Film Fest in the U.S. It's played in Colombia. It's obviously played in Spain because it's a Spanish movie. South Africa, Mexico, Australia, the UK, Finland, South Korea, Portugal, Taiwan, Spain. Again, it's Spanish, but man, oh man, this thing, it gets released in Spain in May, so it's already out in Spain, but it gets released over here. When does it get released over here? I think it's this month. Hang on now, I should know this. No, there is no release date for it over here yet. It played at a film festival. Okay, I'm an idiot. So there's no release date for it over here yet. It gets released in Spain in May. But, I mean, for the amount of film festivals this thing's played at and the amount of awards that it's won, like, it's going to get picked up. And I don't think it's going to come to any theaters, but it's definitely going to go on video and on demand. So I don't know if maybe Netflix will pick it up, or maybe... this seems more like maybe a Shudder-type movie, but... Holy fuck, the trailer looks fucking great. Again, I just did a review about possession. We did a review on it called Hereditary. And then I just did a trailer review for The Devil's Doorway, which is an exorcist type kind of possession movie that it looks like in the trailer. And holy fuck, so, but this woman here, Miriam Martin, who plays Medea, she obviously is possessed by some sort of a demon, because she's sitting there in the fucking living room, you know, moaning or whatever she's doing, and then her eyes go black. So obviously this poor fucker is getting sacrificed over the course of the night, you know what I mean? But maybe they have to do certain rituals to him involving sex. And I mean, there's one tag here in the if you go to taglines, or no, sorry, key plot words, stabbed with scissors. So I don't know. And then there's another one, penis. So there you go, Angela. There's your fucking male and female nudity. And, you know, it just, again, this they're saying don't eat and have sex before you see this movie. So it must just be fucking crazy gore and all sorts of shit. So I will do my very best to find out when this movie actually gets released here in Canada in the U.S. because I really want to see it. I think maybe if you go on some torrent sites or some streaming sites, you might be able to find it there, because it did come out in May in Spain, so I'm sure somebody's thrown it up on a torrent site. But again, you know, to be all legit, you really should pay for the movies you watch. So I don't know. I'll find a release date for this thing. I'm sure it's going to be coming out here relatively soon. So somebody's going to pick this thing up, because it looks fucking crazy. So anyways, it's called Night of the Virgin. Let me know what you think. I think this thing looks fucking great. So again, I just want to say thanks to all the new subscribers. You guys are awesome. Every day there's more and more of you come aboard. Again, I don't monetize this channel. I just love this platform to talk to you guys and have conversations and show these awesome fucking movies. I don't want to make money doing this. I don't need to. I just love talking about horror movies. So anyways, guys, thanks for subscribing. If you haven't, please do so if you want. And also jump over to Happy Wax TV on Facebook and join there as well. and leave me lots of comments, and I do my very best to answer all of you. So anyways, Night of the Virgin, I will find a release date for it, and I'll post it in Happy Wax TV on Facebook. And yeah, until next time, guys, stay scared.